declared disaster areas today, Friday, January 3rd, 1997.
From NBC News, this is Today with Bryant Gumbel and Katie Couric, live from Studio 1A in Rockefeller Plaza.
And good morning. Welcome to Today on this, thank you very much, on this Friday morning, a Friday in which for the, I guess for the fourth straight morning, we have to greet you with bad news from the Pacific Northwest. The rivers over there have overflowed in already 70 counties in five states, Utah, Idaho, Washington, Oregon, and parts of California have already been overrun by the water. And that's a terrible story we've been following all week long.
That's right. We're going to keep up with that at the news desk. And we greet you with some sad news from New York City because, as many people know by now, and as those signs indicated, this is Brian's last morning on the Today Show. How are you doing? How are you feeling?
I'm okay. A little bit apprehensive. This is the first time I ever spent the night before a broadcast with really nothing to do.
Yes, in fact, Brian has a handle on what will be on the show, perhaps better than anyone, and we should show folks at home what your script looked like.
Zero, blank
this
pages.
This morning.
Blank pages. They have managed to keep this whole thing a secret. Usually I'm a bit of a control freak, and so
this just in.
So I've got the routine here on my left and the script here on the right, and the routine they gave me is also blank. And everybody's walking around with theirs, but they're hiding it like somebody's little secret.
Well, I can
it away
tell
in
you
pocket.
That the next 2 hours are going to be packed with memories, a few surprises, and a large supply of these.
Well, I got three hankies working. One here, one in the outside pocket, and one back here.
Oh, so, good. I'm glad you brought one for
me. We'll see who's quick on the draw.
Well, fasten your seatbelt. Enjoy the ride, because it's going to be a joy ride.
Thank you very much. I'm anxious to see what happens. Okay, let's get to the serious business first, and let's go on over to the news desk. Matt fills us in on the flooding and much more. Matt, good morning. How are you doing?
Hi, Brian. Good morning to you. Katie, good morning.
Thanks so very much. Turn our attention to the weather. Mr. Rocare, how are you, sir? Is that the copy of it?
That's the rundown.
We're torturing him.
Want to see it again? Okay. Anyway, let's take a look at the weather. This I can show you.
One little peek.
Anyway, let's check your weather, show you what's going on. I'm putting it inside my shirt. Ooh. We're looking at a lot of weather.
All right, Al. Thanks very much. And here we go. On close-up this morning, Bryant. As everyone knows by now, this is your last morning on this program here on Today. Since coming here 15 years ago, you've broadcast 7,500 hours of live TV, interviewed about 12,000 guests. Can you believe that? Asked about 160,000 questions, and as you'll see as we look back now, reported on every major news event of the last 15 years.
30 back, come on. Somebody on four. We have a take. Five, four, three, two, one.
Here's what we know at this hour. Flight 800 bound for Paris went down shortly after 8 o'clock last night. You're looking at a live picture of what's left of the federal building in Oklahoma City.
I have OJ in the car.
Millions watched as Simpson took police on a bizarre chase through Los Angeles. There are plenty of questions being raised about the way the siege ended. The violence erupted after the acquittal of four white policemen in the beat trial of black motorist Rodney King. The waiting is over in the Gulf. The war has begun.
Welcome to Saudi Arabia. In keeping with Pentagon wishes, we cannot tell you our exact location. Obviously, the people of the Bay have taken a beating, but they're anxious to get on with their lives.
The numbers are terrible. All 258 aboard are dead.
Challenger, go and throttle up.
The toll in Lebanon now stands at 161 Americans dead.
Good morning. This is Today, Monday, January 4th, 1982. I'm Bryant Gumbel. I will resist the urge to say sitting in for Tom Brokaw.
The Today program had been an important part of my early years. I thought it was part of our kind of national treasure, if you will. And I knew that Bryant Gumbel would take care of it.
I remember being told when I first took the job that the idea was that you just held on to it for a little while, that it really wasn't yours, that it was much bigger than that, and that you should try to leave it in better shape than you came to it. And I've always kind of remembered that.
At 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm just just getting in.
The sleep, I know everybody wants to make a big deal of, but I never did. There's a lot of people in this world who get up very early for an awful lot less. They don't want to hear you griping about it.
His work ethic impresses me on a daily basis, and I mean whether it's preparing for the president or preparing for Martha Stewart. He will put in the time to do that interview.
The perfect pie crust.
The perfect. 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour.
He is extremely seamless on the air, and he's an excellent live broadcaster. I think he's one of the best in the business, if not the best.
I think there are very few jobs, if any, on this earth where you could each and every day look forward to dealing with a prime minister, followed by a prize-winning author, followed by a famous cook, followed by the latest Hollywood ingenue. I think that kind of variety is absolutely wonderful.
Wow! I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good. So good. I got you.
Before I ever got in television, I'd never even been west of the Mississippi. Before I went away to college, I'd never even been on a plane. Going overseas, you gotta be kidding.
I'm a traveling man, made a lot of stops all over the world.
Buenos dias, bienvenidos, aloy, and Buenos Aires. Good morning and welcome to Today from Buenos Aires. Dobre utro, Jane, and welcome to the Soviet Union. Good morning, Katie, or as the locals here would say, Mangwanani. Welcome to Dublin, or as I understand the natives call it, Balya Akhtia. Welcome to Saudi Arabia, where the correct greeting is Salam Aleikum.
And Bonjia. Benvenu in Ojo Rio. I knew I'd mess it up. Good morning and welcome to Today from Rio.
I see trees of green. Red roses too.
Just another day at the office.
Yes, just another day at the office. The Sphinx was protected under sand until 1926.
We are very proud of the fact that we are the first broadcast to come out of Ho Chi Minh City live.
What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
The Zimbabwe side.
Are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking.
Happy Easter, Your Holiness. My goodness. This is a whole different world, Kevin. Thank you very much.
I believe that if you were to get him in the weakest moment, he would probably say the greatest thing about the travel is not necessarily seeing the Colosseum, but eating an Italian restaurant, because he likes to eat.
Bryant loves food.
He loves to eat.
I love to eat. I've always loved to eat.
I'll have some clam chowder followed by beefsteak on rye, pumpkin pie, whipped cream and coffee.
You know what I ate last night? Duck feet. The head cheese is spectacular. What about a little pate? You're sure I can't interest you in a peanut butter stuffed jalapeno?
How does one eat a
winkle?
A winkle. How does one eat a winkle?
I want a green salad on the side. Don't forget the french fries, pizza pie, garlic and anchovy.
That should last you a couple weeks.
Yes, thank you very much. You know what else you got to taste while you're here? Jellyfish. I think we have to get a couple of sea urchins for Katie. This is pretty good. You want more?
No, go ahead. Knock yourself out.
I'll try anything. And over my time here, I've eaten witchetty grubs, which are moth larvae. I've drank snake blood. I've eaten, ate a live caterpillar.
I don't believe I just did that.
There isn't a lot I won't try, with one exception. Cheese. It's time to do fromage. I'm going in. Here's a guy who, you know, eats peppers that would take most people's heads off. Yet you show him a grilled cheese sandwich and he faints.
Speaking of food, then there was the garlic incident. The famous, because he's got a bit of a mean streak.
And you always serve garlic with it?
This was in Seoul, right before the Olympics in South Korea. He hands me this, what I think is a water chestnut or something. And I put it in my mouth.
It kind of looks like garlic, but it's more...
I had to excuse myself.
She's really wimping out on me, didn't she? Oh. What else do we got here?